Hello everyone, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video, we are going to talk about the fungal classification. So we have talked that fungi has been classified into four groups. So in this video, we are going to talk about the first group of classification of the fungi, which is known as phycomycetes. So let's see what are these. These are also known as the algal fungi. So they have been given a common name, which is the algal fungi. They have the presence of accepted sinusitic hyphae. Accepted, we mean that the hyphae is not separated by the presence of septum or the septa. So they are accepted. The protoplasm is continuous in these type of hyphae, and they are the sinusitic hyphae. They are mostly branched. The sexual reproduction, which occurs in these type of phycomycetes, they are mostly isogamous, and or they can also be heterogamous. So what do we mean by isogamous type of sexual reproduction? Here the male and the female gametes, they can be of similar shape, structure, so they can be basically of the similar type. Whereas heterogamous type of sexual reproduction means that these two gametes can be of different texture, shape, structure, etc. So these are the two types by which sexual reproduction can take place in the phycomycetes group. Now the heterogamous type of sexual reproduction, they can be again anisogamous, which means that the two types of gametes we are talking about, they can be absolutely different, whereas they can also be oogamous. What do we mean by oogamous type of sexual reproduction or heterogamous sexual reproduction? Here a small motile male gamete fertilizes with a larger non-motile female gamete. So the female gamete is larger and it cannot move, whereas the male gametes are smaller and they can move, and in turn they fertilize the female gametes. This group, they are divided into two main groups. First, the oomycetes and the zygomycetes. Now we are going to talk about these two groups in detail. So first let us talk about the group which is known as the oomycetes. So what are these? These also have the, as we are talking, that generally they have the sinusitic mycelium. They are multinucleated as well as accepted. That means their protoplasm is not separated by the presence of septa. The hyphal wall, it contains materials which are cellulose and also are the some basic types of glucans. So the hyphal wall is composed of cellulose as well as glucans. The asexual reproduction, it can happen in these type of oomycetes. It occurs mostly by the formation of sporangia. Now sporangia, these are spores which are formed by these type of structures, and these sporangia, they are mostly formed at the tip of the hyphae. These special tip of the hyphae, they have been given a name which are known as sporangiophore. So in the sporangiophore, these sporangia or the spores are formed, which actually helps in the reproduction, that is a asexual mode of reproduction. Now the zoospores, they are mostly biflagellated, that means presence of two flagella with heterocon flagellation. So what do we mean by heterocon type of flagellation? Here one of the flagella, it is of smooth texture, whereas the other flagella, it may be of the tensile texture. So here one is smooth and the other is tensile, hence they are biflagellated and has been given a name, that is heterocon flagellation. The sexual reproduction, if it happens in these type of oomycetes, what happens? It occurs by the gametangel contact, that is simple contact between the male and the female. That is the male antheridium, what happens? It passes on its content into the female oogonium. So here through the fertilization tube, this passing happens from the antheridium male part to the female oogonium, and this is via the sexual reproduction, which is basically we can see through gametangel contact. The production of the sexual reproduction, because of the sexual reproduction, it results in the production of a oospore. Now let's look into the second group, which is known as the zygomycetes. So what are these? These also have sinusitic mycelium. They are similarly multinucleated and accepted like that of the oomycetes, which we have already discussed. They have, the difference here is the hyphal wall, they have got special materials which are known as chitin, whereas in the previous case we have seen that they have got cellulose and other glucans, but here they have got the material called as, or the substance called as chitin. The spores, they are non-motile sporangiospores are formed, which are formed inside the sporangia, similar to that of the previous type. Like in the tips of the hyphae or the sporangiophore, these sporangia or the spores are formed, but they are non-motile. They cannot move. The sexual reproduction, if it happens, then it is mostly by conjugation. This is simple contact between the male and the female through the conjugation tube. This sexual reproduction can happen in case of zygomycetes. Now, the gametes which are involved in this type of sexual reproduction, they are mostly multinucleated, and hence they have been given a name or terminology which is known as the synogametes. So, multinucleated gametes are known as the synogametes, which actually happens in case of zygomycetes, sexual type of reproduction. Now, because of this sexual type of reproduction, it results in the formation of a zygospore, and in the previous case we have seen that it resulted in the formation of a oospore, whereas in this case it results in the formation of a zygospore. So, in this video we have talked about the first group of fungi, which is zygomycetes, which is basically phycomycetes, and here we have discussed two groups, which is oomycetes and the zygomycetes. So, I hope you have understood and liked this video. Thank you.